I should. But then again, what's the point of having fuck you money if you never say fuck you?
Today, I want to take a break from the usual finance stuff. No credit cards, no ETFs, no stock market. Instead, I want to talk about something that's really close to my heart, and that's movies. Because I have several passions in my life. Finance, obviously, is one of them. That's why I'm running this channel. But movies is really something that I've fallen in love with as a kid. And under normal circumstances, I am known to go to the movies 3 to 4 times a week when there's obviously no pandemics. So today I want to marry the two. I want to talk about finance movies, movies that inspired me to get into finance, but also movies that really taught me something about finance. Because when you think about why we watch movies, right? We watch movies because they either inspire us, they teach us, or they entertain us. And occasionally you have that magic sauce where you find all three in one. Let me tell you which finance movies made my top 10. Here are the rules of the game. I'm going to give you a 30-second elevator pitch on each of the 10 movies on my list. Explain why they inspired me, what they meant to me, and why they are obviously part of my top 10. So movie number one, I'm going to go a little bit soft here. It's one of the two movies from the 80s on my list. And it's a movie that really meant a lot to me when I was growing up back in Europe, learning English by watching MTV. A movie that really put me on the potential imaginary trajectory to Wall Street one day. And it's The Working Girl.
This woman is my secretary.
She's not?
Oh, no? Ask her.
I'm telling you, she's your man.
Maybe I just don't like you.
Me? Nah.
Now, I'm going to defend this movie fiercely against anybody. It's a true classic of the underdog, a secretary from the Long Island, getting on the ferry, coming to Manhattan, trying to make it in the world of finance and on Wall Street in the 80s, right? A completely different world to what we see today. But this movie meant a lot to me when I was growing up, obviously dreamt about one day coming to America, working on Wall Street. And 15 years later, I did end up working on Wall Street. Movie number two on my list is a movie with Nicolas Cage and Téa Leoni called The Family Man. Now, there's so many valuable lessons in this movie, but it was very personal to me when I was only starting to interview in finance and getting my first jobs. There is a line in this movie that Nicolas Cage has, which I completely reproduced in one of my interviews, and it got me the job.
And you're a man who prides himself in finding talent in unusual places.
How would you know that?
Because I'm here. I'm prepared to do whatever it takes to get this job. I'll start wherever I have to start. I'll park cars if I have to. The biggest part of judging character is knowing yourself, and I know this. I can do this job. I can. Give me a chance, Peter. I won't let you down.
The next two movies on my list are both real classics, and both are based on real-life events. Movie number three is The Rogue Trader, and this is a story that happened in the mid-90s, if you remember. And when you watch the movie today, you know, 21 or 25 years later, this looks incredibly dated when you think about how technology evolved and what trading floors look like today. I mean, look at this.
We need another £2 million profit to secure our bonuses.
Ron, what planet do you live on, mate?
Think about Nick and perhaps come up with ideas to follow his footsteps. You're
just
too good
to be true. Just worked out the balance in the AIDS account. The losses are over $10 million.
Keep your voice down. Everything will be all right so long as we balance the books by the end of the month.
Gamble.
That's all the market is. One giant casino.
So again, a true classic, one of the largest scandals of recent financial history, a story of one man single-handedly sinking the world's second biggest merchant bank back in the mid-90s. And effectively, Barings then ended up selling itself for £1 to ING. Movie number four on my list really needs absolutely no introduction, and that's, of course, Wall Street.
The point is, ladies and gentlemen, that greed, for lack of a better word, is good. Greed is right. Greed works. Greed clarifies, cuts through, and captures the essence of the evolutionary spirit. Greed, in all of its forms, greed for life, for money, for love, knowledge has marked the upward surge of mankind, and greed, you mark my words, will not only save Teldar paper, but that other malfunctioning corporation called the USA. Thank you very much.
Now, this movie came out in 1987 and truly captured an era, the era of the 80s, of the excesses of drugs and money on Wall Street. But also, not many people realize that it's actually inspired by a real-life story of Rudy Giuliani, who was a prosecutor in New York back then, going after Ivan Boesky. So again, a real-life classic that completely captured an era. Movie number five on the list is called Enron, The Smartest Guys in the Room.
It's taken Enron 16 years to go from about 10 billion of assets to 65 billion of assets. It took them 24 days to go bankrupt.
You guys stole from those poor grandmothers.
To argue about my compensation, and if I step on somebody's throat on the way, that doubles it. Well, I'll stomp on the guy's throat.
He just steals money from California to the tune of $1 million or two a day.
Can we rephrase that?
How exactly does Enron make its money?
Accounting doesn't get that creative.
I would like to know if you are on crack.
This is the shredded evidence.
Welcome to the 21st century. Really, the collapse of Enron and the Enron Corporation in 2001 was really the first big scandal of the 21st century. A scandal that everybody that's interested in finance, studies finance, or wants to get into finance should learn and know about, and the whole involvement of Enron in the California electricity crisis. More of a documentary style type of a movie, but very important to see. Movie number six on my list is called The Margin Call, which came out in 2011. Now, this is one of the first movies on my list that kind of deals with the 2008 financial crisis, but really shows what happens when an overleveraged financial investment firm gets a margin.
I'm very sorry.
I was working on something, but they wouldn't let me finish it. So take a look at it. Be careful.
Is that figure right?
Looks pretty right to me.
If those assets decrease by just 25%, that loss would be greater than the current market capitalization of this entire company.
You cannot be doing what you're thinking of doing.
Sell it all today.
You're selling something that you know has no value.
So that we may survive.
This is an amazing movie that was filmed as a 24-hour window, and it's really fast-paced, gripping. It kind of shows you the cascade of events that we have seen at so many firms in 2008 during the financial crisis. Movie number seven on my list is called The Big Short, which came out in 2015 and is based on the book by the same name from Michael Lewis.
Time off. So Mike Burry, who gets his hair cut at Supercuts and doesn't wear shoes, knows more than Alan Greenspan.
Dr. Mike Burry, yes, he does.
You know what? I'm pissed off. American people are getting screwed by the big banks.
And I am getting madder and madder.
It's unbelievable.
Then this guy walks into my office and says,
there's some shady stuff going down. A few outsiders saw when no one else could.
The whole world economy might collapse.
And we can profit off of their stupidity.
You want to bet against the banks?
I think we're either high or having a stroke.
How can the banks let this happen?
It's fueled by stupidity.
But that's not stupidity, that's fraud.
Tell me the difference between stupid and illegal, and I'll have my wife's brother arrested.
Not going to be able to refinance.
On all my loans?
What do you mean, all your loans?
I have five houses and a condo.
Now, I really love this story, and the movie is so well made. It's based on, obviously, real-life people, a few people that foresaw what was coming in 2006 and 7 and bet big money against the investment banks, which were on the other side of the trade, and obviously came out making a ton of money for themselves and their investors. Movie number eight on my list is The Inside Job, which won an Oscar for the best documentary.
Brothers was forced to declare itself bankrupt.
Regulators, they had the power to do every case that I made when I was state attorney general. They just didn't want to.
Bear Stearns, Goldman Sachs, Lehman Brothers, they knew what was happening.
What do you think about selling securities which your own people think are crap? Does that bother you
as a hypothetical?
No, this is real.
Our risk takers, they're impulsive. I see a lot of cocaine use, prostitution.
So do these guys know that they were doing something dangerous?
I think they did.
Why do you think there isn't a more systematic investigation being undertaken?
Because then you'll find the culprits.
I don't believe I have to discuss that with you.
This movie is really important. First of all, there's great cinematography, high-profile interviews. It's narrated by Matt Damon. But this movie really ties it all together. The previous three movies that I talked about were really dealing with the financial crisis of 2007, 8, and 9. And The Inside Job really ties it all together because you see real-life people, real interviews, and it kind of explains extremely well what actually happened back then. So for any student of finance, anybody that's serious about finance, this is a movie that's an absolute must. And we're getting to the finish line here. Movie number 9 on my list is The Wolf of Wall Street, which when it came out, received 5 Oscar nominations.
$49 million, which really pissed me off because it was 3 shy of a million a week.
Was all this legal? Absolutely not. We were making more money than we knew what to do with.
Oh my God.
FBI, any kind of booze you might want?
No, the Bureau forbids us from drinking.
So follow me, you could about the door. If I knew what I knew in the past, I would have.
1, 2, 3!
Stop.
We don't want to get a bad reputation.
Remember when this movie came out, it was pretty controversial. If you have seen it or haven't seen it, go watch it. Absolutely. This is, again, portraying a typical era of late 20th century of all the excesses that we have seen. For some people, this was hardly credible. When I watched it, I wasn't kind of surprised with what I was seeing, but certainly entertaining how DiCaprio was portraying Jordan Belfort, which ultimately, again, this is based on real life events, went to prison for what he did and how he scammed his investors. All right, I saved the absolutely best for the last, and it's a show called The Billions. So we had 9 movies, and this is a show, but I truly think Billions is the best thing on TV around finance right now.
Consequences, intended and unintended. The decisions we make, the actions we bring, have weight. Come to work every day and be just and strong in the actions you bring, and don't waver.
When did it become a crime to succeed in this country? Everyone has access to the information. We just know how to analyze it better.
We spotted a suspect trading pattern.
You must get pings like that every day.
All 3 firms have links to Bobby Axelrod.
What'd you take down last year?
$7.2 million.
Your value to the firm is absolute.
I'm the goddamn U.S. attorney, Wendy.
Are we teaching them that daddy's job is always more important than mommy's? Quit your fucking job.
It's like Highlander. There can be only one.
Are you threatening me? You're fucking right I am.
You wouldn't know the right thing to do if it kneeled down and sucked your tiny goddamn cock!
Walk away.
I should. But then again, what's the point of having fuck you money if you never say fuck you?
This show really gives you the most accurate description of the world of high finance, how it's interconnected with politics. The shady characters. It teaches you in every single episode something about what's current in the world of finance. But also, the writing is just amazing. The characters are completely flawed. And I'm warning you, you're going to find yourself rooting for the bad guys because Billions really doesn't have any good guys. But even if you're not into finance or if somebody in your family is not into finance, this is something that is extremely enjoyable. It's a great show. It's just great, great entertainment that also teaches you something about finance. All right, so that's my top 10. So many other movies did make it in my top 10, but there are so many amazing movies. I'm leaving the list below this video, so check out the list for inspiration of what to watch. I certainly, like I said in the beginning, use a lot of these movies and Billions as a way to entertain myself, but also to learn, to get inspired. And I hope that, you know, what a better way for other people that are getting into finance or that are in finance than to watch some really cool stories about the industry they love or they're getting into. Thank you for listening. I really hope you enjoy this. Give a like to the video if you did. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. More regular content on finance and actual finance subjects in the days to come. Thank you for listening again, and I'll see you in a few days.